योगः कर्मसु कौशलम्।
Welcome to online refresher course in English language teaching of Ministry of Human Resource Development, National Resource Center of Gujarat University. I am Professor Dr. Jagdish Joshi, the Director of UGC Human Resource Development Center of Gujarat University and Course Coordinator of the online refresher course in English language teaching. I would like to welcome and introduce the resource person of today. Namaskar, ma'am.
Namaskar.
Professor Shabina Omar is at present serving as Head Department of English in Mili Al Amin College for Girls affiliated to University of Calcutta. She has served as Principal in Charge of the institution for more than 15 years. She has also been previously associated as Head of Department of English at Aliyah University and played a key role in framing the draft syllabus for the Department of English in that university. She has nearly two decades of teaching experience in English language and literature at UG and PG levels. She has won great acclaim of her critical and creative writings in several national and international books and journals. She is also an empaneled invited resource person for Oxford University Press and conducts pan-India teacher training workshops on enhancing professional competences and skill development, effective teaching strategies, English language teaching, and motivation of self and learners. An academician, writer, orator, gender activist, and motivational speaker cum professional skill trainer who considers herself to be a lifelong scholar. Professor Omar is dedicated and committed to the cause of empowerment through education and skill development. It is a pleasure to have her as a resource person in this online refresher course in English. Welcome, ma'am.
Namaskar, and thank you very much, sir. It is indeed a pleasure and a privilege to be associated with this immensely significant and meaningful approach to teacher training. It is quite an innovation to impart training digitally in an online refresher course. And I must say that it will truly be a unique experience, which I am sincerely looking forward to. The topic for today is English language teaching in India, skills and competences. A major reality of our country is that even today, English language in India is taught usually as simply a subject and mainly through literature in many academic institutions. Hence, the effective use of English as a globally acknowledged and relevant skill is not inculcated by many of the learners. Such an online refresher course, sir, I hope, will empower the teachers to identify and highlight the skills and competences they need to make their students imbibe and utilize. Before I begin my formal presentation, I would like to make a few things very clear. What I am doing here is not presenting any research paper. I have curated and collated myriad ideas from various valuable sources, enriched them with authentic inputs, and tried to provide some guidelines for effective English language teaching in which English is imparted as a skill and can enhance both professional and personal competence. This has relevance to the field of teaching in general and my field of English teaching in particular. Secondly, I am not here to give a lecture in the general sense of the term. I am here to share certain experiences. I am here to learn and empower the participants. I am here to learn from them It is going to be a kind of a symbiotic relationship, a give and take kind of an encounter where we can empower each other and grow together, share experiences. I am not here to dispense nuggets of wisdom, but I am here rather to share a few ideas which I leave up to you, the target audience, to decide whether they are valuable to be used in your classes or not valuable and can be rejected. I would, of course, love feedback and constructive criticism, and I hope that we can enjoy this learning journey together. It is up to the takers of this course to transform themselves and their competences and implement the ideas being propagated henceforth in their classrooms. So I am looking towards this refresher course as having several far-reaching repercussions and positive outcomes. Let us regard this training as an empowering experience of mutual development.
Your motivating response to the concept of the refresher course has really enheartened me and stimulated my interest. Will you give us a brief idea about the module you have prepared?
Regarding the module I have prepared, before I summarize the content, allow me to ask you something.
Yes, ma'am.
Something that is a nagging worry in the minds of all language educators. Mm-hmm. And sir, we have all been language teachers. We still are language teachers.
True.
We are educational administrators, but mm-hmm. the bottom line is that we remain teachers. In your wide experience mm-hmm. with teaching in general and English language teaching in particular, mm-hmm. what would you say are the biggest maladies that contribute to ineffective English language teaching in India?
Yes, if we talk of the biggest maladies that contribute to ineffective English language teaching in Indian educational institutions, I guess there are lack of focus on the vital concerns of the subject.
Yes.
The neglect of teaching the linguistic skills required for professional and personal development, ineffective assessment practices, and unskilled or less effective teaching. I guess these are some of them.
Sir, you have exactly summed up what my module seeks to address. My submission is that English is largely taught in our country to prepare for examinations and not for life. The basic vital English language skills, which we know as LSRW, listening, speaking, reading and writing, are usually neglected while being taught in a classroom environment because, sir, my experience is that in most institutions of higher education, English teaching is grammar-centric or purely connected to teaching literature, and it is usually done very mechanically and often in a very abstract manner. The focus then shifts more to theoretical knowledge, which has to be ingested and regurgitated, if I may use those words very strongly, to achieve marks rather than on the acquisition and enhancement of vocational skills. Assessment plays an important role in testing the language skills of learners, but most language tests evaluate the student's memory, rote skills, and not their critical thinking or critical reading and life skills. What, sir, I have also seen is that many teachers teaching in higher education institutions have not been particularly trained to teach English as a skill. Learning a language means also learning a skill. And therefore, English must be taught as a skill, and the focus must be on the four essentials known as LSRW, listening, speaking, reading and writing.
Yes, learners can acquire language skills like thinking, listening, speaking, reading and writing only if they have sufficient practice in the language. So I say practice plays a major role here.
Yes, it does, because it is known that practice, they say, makes a man perfect. I totally agree with you, sir. And in the light of our discussion so far, I would like to ask you that given this scenario, given that we are all victims of the scenario, many of us are struggling to encounter the scenario and negotiate the realities as best as possible. What do you think should be the goals of English language teaching in India?
I think that the goals of English language teaching in India should be to be able to speak and write correctly and communicate effectively in both general and professional environments. To understand systematic aspects of the different uses of the English language. To be able to understand and analyze the evolution of written English literature and its various dimensions. To acquire knowledge about primary and even canonical English texts, authors and literary movements. To learn the basics of translations from native languages to English and English to native languages. These are, I think, the important goals. At the same time, I believe that the skills, if they acquire, that they should communicate to people in written and oral both the ways, then only they can attain the skills of languages.
I agree with you, and these are very valuable suggestions with which we can take this module forward. Based on your valuable inputs, I would like to suggest that the goals you have highlighted with such clarity can only be achieved if we have two kinds of competences being developed within our teachers: personal competences and systemic competences. Personal competences should include that the English language teachers develop in their learners a capacity for analysis and synthesis and for critical thinking. Second, a concern about general and specific knowledge of human history and culture in terms of linguistic and philological evolution. Next, a command over the English language from different grammatical perspectives. And there can be a whole range of grammatical perspectives: phonetic, phonological, lexical, morphological, semantic, discursive, pragmatic, stylistic, and even sociolinguistic. The ability to speak and write in English with correctness, fluency, and communicative efficiency, as you just said, is very essential in everyday situations, especially in academic and professional environments. To understand the diachronic evolution of the English language, as well as the reasons for and parameters of its implementation as a global language. These, I think, would summarize the personal competences needed. The systemic competences should include the inculcation of teamwork skills and abilities concerning work relationships, knowledge and sensitivity towards cultural diversity. In both cases, language plays a major role. The ability to plan and organize academic work and research in any interdisciplinary area related to language, and also the ability to communicate multilingually. The ability to use linguistic terminology and language techniques specific to a particular professional environment. The knowledge and practical command of rhetoric, stylistic, and other resources linked to the process of the literary creation and the objective optimization of, as you said, oral and written communication in the English language. The ability to analyze, evaluate, and correct oral and written English texts. The critical, theoretical, and practical knowledge, and the ability to participate in the design of interpersonal communication. So, with this combination of personal and systemic competences, I believe an English teacher can evolve into a better professional in and outside the classroom.
Let me ask you a question. Do you have in mind any specific strategies that ELT teachers can adopt in their classrooms to become more effective?
Yes, indeed I do. Yeah. And I'm very glad you asked this question. Because, sir, we've all heard about good teachers being born.
True.
But today's age requires the transformation, or should I say the transition, of a teacher from good to effective.
True.
The classroom today is a fluid space. It mm-hmm. is culturally diverse. And teaching learning is not a process of one-way chalk and talk.
Very true.
It is now becoming an interactive and multifaceted experience. So today, I think the biggest strategy for any language teacher, or for any teacher for that matter, is that they must transform themselves, or should I correct myself and say, we must transform ourselves. We, the teaching fraternity, must transform ourselves from good teachers to effective teachers.
True.
By change, by innovation, because after all, as they say, change is the only constant in life and innovation is mandatory. To reiterate this, I wish to share with you a very short but a very relevant film clip which highlights the requirements of skills, abilities, and knowledge in the right ratio, in the right proportion, at the right place, and in the right direction. So let us watch a short film.
This is the need of the hour. Innovation and change are the mandatory professional requirements of today. In fact, there is a need to introspect and empower ourselves. Change is the only constant. We must embrace the change from within to equip ourselves for the future. I'm looking forward to a comprehensive understanding of skills and competences in ELT in our module today.
Thank you. I am looking forward to presenting a very comprehensive module on skills and competences in English language teaching today. I shall now take the module forward in the next segments on the basis of the discussion we have just had.